Hey, Kyle Sulerud here, and in this video, I'm going to take you inside Vid Hoarder so you can see everything that this tool is capable of and how it will help you build and scale winning YouTube ads campaigns, because it's going to help you find the very best targeting so you can put your ads in front of the right people at the right time on YouTube. So I'm going to be showing you the placement finder, the channel scraper, and the keyword generator, as well as some extra tools within the placement finder. But I'm gonna start with the placement finder. This is really the backbone of Vid Hoarder. This is how it all started before we started adding additional features. And with the placement finder, we can type in a keyword search and then return a large list of video links that we can then add to a YouTube campaign as placement targeting. So how it works, you just enter a keyword. So if I want to search how to play guitar, because I have a product that would help people learn how to play guitar, I can select up to 500 results. And then this is going to fetch from YouTube directly the top 500 results that would show up when someone types how to play guitar. This isn't just one page of results. This is several pages of results coming from YouTube, and you can see it loads all of these results pretty much right away. We don't always get 500 results, but we get up to 500 results at a time, whatever YouTube sends us, and the number of results is gonna show up right here. So then you can see that this actually starts with the top results. If you go to YouTube and search this same keyword, you're going to get these same results. You can then select the placements that you want to target. Okay, just like this. You could also, if you want, you could select all of the placements. Okay, you can select all of these at once. If you want, you could unselect some of these. Once you've selected what you want, or let's say you just want to select all of these, you can then copy the links. That will save all of these URLs to your clipboard. Then you just go into Google Ads, go into your YouTube campaign, and paste these into your placement targeting. It's that simple. You can also export this into a spreadsheet. So if you prefer to work with this information in a spreadsheet, you can export right here. And that is the basics of the placement finder. Now I'm going to get into the top channels and top phrases in a moment. These are actually the features I'm most excited about right now. Our team has been working very hard getting these ready. And I'm excited to show those to you in a minute, but I want to first show you the channel scraper and the keyword generator. Now for the channel scraper, we are going to need a channel that we want to scrape. So let me just copy a channel link before I go over there. So what the channel scraper does is returns all of the video URLs from a particular channel, or at least up to 500, okay, depending on how many videos a channel has. This may or may not be all of their videos. So from this one channel, we have all the videos from this channel. The reason this is important, and this was kind of discovered on accident, if you are just targeting a channel, which you absolutely should be doing, if this is a good channel for your audience, this should be targeted in your campaign. That'll get you a certain amount of traffic. What we have found is that if you are also targeting the individual videos from that channel, you will get even more traffic. I don't know why the system works that way, but it does. So in addition to targeting the channel, which will make your ad eligible to show on any video from the channel, you'll get more traffic by also targeting every individual video from that channel. And that's what this channel scraper does. Now, if you want, you can sort this by views from high to low. Okay, sometimes there'll be a video on a channel that doesn't necessarily go with the theme of the channel, and it might have millions of views. So you might not want to copy that over. But that's an easy way to do it, is to sort this by views. This is the channel scraper. So all of the good channels that you want to target, you're going to want to take them here into the channel scraper. And then it works the same way, where you can select all the results. You can unselect some of them if you want, and then you can copy them, paste them, or you can export them into a spreadsheet. Next thing I want to show you is the keyword generator. With the keyword generator, we're going to generate keyword ideas. And this uses predictive search data from YouTube and from Google. So if I enter how to play guitar here, and I leave YouTube as the source, this is going to generate keywords for me based on this root keyword. So you can see how to play guitar for beginners, for kids. All of these results were generated based on the how to play guitar keyword. Here too, if you want, you can select all of these, you can copy them, you can export them. Now, this is an instance where you probably don't want to just export all of these keywords and target all of them in a keyword campaign. Instead, this is meant to give you ideas. So you will likely just want to select certain keywords here to target, and you can use these in keyword campaigns. You can use them to build custom audiences. Now, you can also change the source from YouTube to Google. So these are the keywords people are typing into YouTube. We can look at the keywords people are typing into Google by changing the source, and there are going to be different results here because people are searching differently on YouTube and Google. And then again, you can select what you want from the list. Now, let's say I found a good keyword here, and I want to actually take this into the placement finder and see the placements that come along with that. We can do this with one click right here. Search placements is going to bring this keyword, how to play guitar for beginners. It's going to bring it over to the placement finder. And now I can search for this keyword. Now you see this actually opened up a new tab. So these are the results here, how to play guitar for beginners. We got 500 results. We still have the results here for how to play guitar. And I'll show you why that's important in just a second. Let's open up another search. Okay, so right now I'm on this tab. What I'll do is open up a new tab, and maybe I'll type in guitar tutorials. And we'll get 500 results for that. And I could open up a couple more tabs if I want. Once these results load, it'll let me open up more tabs. So this one, you see, not quite 500 results, but YouTube sent us back 494 results. So these tabs, this is important for these two features here that I told you I was excited about: the top channels and top phrases. So the channel search, if we're going to YouTube and searching for channels on a certain subject, the results we get back aren't really very good. I don't know if you've ever done that, but the results that YouTube gives us if we're just trying to find channels really aren't that good. So rather than try to incorporate those poor results into Vid Hoarder, we wanted to find our own way to get results and our own way to get top channels for certain subjects. So when we go over to top channels, what we're going to see is for all of these tabs combined. So we have almost 1500 results here. Some of them might be duplicates. They likely are, since these are similar keywords. But we have up to 1500 results showing so far. It's going to show me the frequency that these channels are appearing in these results. So obviously, if we're seeing the same channels over and over in these results, those channels are going to be pretty relevant to the keywords. If they have that many individual videos that are ranking for those keywords, then the channel itself is likely going to be a good channel. And that's exactly what we're going to see in top channels. So when we go to top channels, this channel, Marty Music, has 246 videos in our results. Now, if we want, we can verify if this would be a good channel. We can go over to Marty Music here and see what this channel is. Obviously, it's all about learning guitar. So would this be a good channel to target? Yes, absolutely. We can target that channel. We can copy it, take it over to the channel scraper, and we're going to see several channels like this, channels that we're not going to find in any other search, but by seeing which channels are showing up most often in the video results, we're going to find some extremely relevant channels that we can target in our placement campaigns. So that is the top channels. Now, let me show you top phrases. Top phrases are the phrases that are being pulled out of the video titles. Okay, so each of these videos has a name, and there are some common phrases appearing over and over in these videos. Guitar lesson, guitar tutorial. These obviously would make good keywords if we are trying to target for this topic with keywords or custom audiences. Now, this will show us the top results from 2-word phrases, 3-word phrases, 4-word phrases. If I want to toggle off the 2-word phrases and just see 3 words, that shows up here. And this gives us some great ideas. Guitar lesson tutorial, easy guitar tutorial. Okay, obviously we don't want to include all of these again. Like this isn't specific to guitar. It just happened to be a common phrase in those results. But when we're finding results specific to guitar and it looks like it would be a good keyword for us, we can take these into keyword campaigns, custom audience campaigns, or potentially search for them again in the placement finder. We can toggle out 3-word phrases. So now we're only seeing 4-word phrases, and you can see that this is giving us some really good keywords to think about. So that is the tool. That's what I wanted to share with you today. I hope you got a lot out of this video and started thinking about some ways that you can target and get in front of your ideal customer with YouTube ads and how Vid Hoarder can help you do that quicker and give you ideas that you cannot get anywhere else. Thanks for watching. I will talk to you later.